Greetings, fellow nerds. In a previous video, I showed the pH meter and the basic approach of calibrating one. But cheaper meters had a problem that slope errors could not be corrected for. For a lot of reactions, this tiny error isn't an issue, and calibrating to the point closest to the expected pH of your reaction is usually enough. On a more advanced instrument, the onboard computer would automatically compensate. But to save money, we're just going to use your personal computer along with a spreadsheet and some math. First, get a few different pH calibration buffer solutions. I'm going to use three. After physically calibrating your meter with one solution as best you can, measure all three solutions and then plot the measured readings versus the known pH as a scatter plot in a spreadsheet. Then simply add a linear trend line through all the points. This is also known as a linear regression. Now you have a calibrated curve that compensates for the non-idealities of your glass electrode. To use the curve, simply take a reading, then go into the spreadsheet and substitute your reading for Y, and then solve for X. The value you get will be your properly calibrated pH reading. Now a glass electrode can drift a lot in terms of readings, so even if you calibrated yesterday, it can drift to something different today. It's best to recalibrate before doing an experiment. Now, as great as the calibration curve is, it can't make a bad electrode into a good one, so the electrode itself should be of high quality if you want to get high quality data. Garbage in, garbage out, as they say. Nonetheless, with some buffer solutions, a spreadsheet, and some thought, we've turned a $40 pH meter and electrode we got off eBay into a usable analytical tool that can compete with a several hundred dollar model. Now, glass electrodes do not last forever. As it wears out, it will respond extremely slowly to changes in pH. It will be erratic, or the calibration curve will be badly distorted. Now, it may simply need some maintenance like a refilling or a cleaning, and you should consult your electrode manual on the procedure. But eventually you'll have to replace it. All pH electrodes are connected by a standardized BNC connector. Just disconnect the electrode and keep the meter. You can then connect another electrode to it. We're going to be using pH measurements in upcoming videos. Thanks for watching.